Dear students, welcome to the online learning class for the subject Fundamentals of Agricultural Economics. Today we are going to see about cost and return concepts. So in last class we have seen about production. So for production we use different inputs and it will give us the output. So inputs are recorded as X and outputs are recorded as Y. So the for purchase of these inputs we make expenditures. So that expenditures are called as the cost. So after we get the production, the output that is sold in the market. So when we sell it in the market we get return. So we are going to see these two concepts in our class. So particularly we are going to see about cost concepts and curves, returns and profit. So this cost minus returns will give the profit of the production. So first we will see about the cost. As we have mentioned earlier, the cost is nothing but the production. Sorry, the expenses for production. So the expenses or expenditures made during the production are called as cost. So why we are making expenditure is we have to provide the input. For purchase of this input we incur cost. Then the money value of all inputs used are called as the cost. So let's say that we are making jam. So for fruit jam we are making. For fruit jam we have to use the inputs like fruits, sugar, chemical additives, labors, electricity, etc. So these things are required for jam making. So these fruits, sugar, chemicals, etc. Their money value is called as cost. So these are all when together called as the cost of production of jam. So particular jam product, for particular jam production we incur this much cost, like that we will tell. So similarly for our agriculture commodity also we incur cost for purchase of seed, fertilizer, chemicals, labors, etc. So for it is for the purchase of input, the expenditures made for purchase of inputs. So how it is estimated? So it is estimated by multiplying the unit input with its price. So how much input we are using and its respective price. For example, for paddy production we use seed. So 30 kg per acre we are using. So this 30 kg and the price of seed is 30 rupees per kg. So when this the seed quantity used is 30 kg and the price of seed is 30 kg, then the cost of seed is 30 kg into 30 rupees per kg. That is how much unit we are using and into its price. So how much price we are going to offer. So this 30 kg into 30 rupees will give 900 rupees. So 900 rupees is the expenditures incurred, the cost incurred for purchase of seeds. Similarly, when we want to purchase fertilizer called urea, so urea requirement is, let's say that urea requirement is 50 kg. And urea is priced at 7 rupees per kg. Then the cost for urea is 50 into 7, that is 350 rupees. So similarly, all the inputs cost is arrived. So all the input cost is arrived, and when added we get the total cost. So when we use n number of inputs like x1, x2, x3, xn, and the prices are quoted as px1, px2, px3, then the total cost is the price into unit quantity. So how much price it is and its unit quantity. So similarly, for all the inputs is calculated and added. So it is just the variable cost. So we can tell it as variable cost. Let's see what is a variable cost in the next slide. So there are two cost concepts, two major cost, that is variable cost and fixed cost. So variable means it is varying in nature. Varying means changeable, so they change. And fixed means it will not change. So fixed means they do not change. So this let's see about the fixed cost. So for particular production, let's say that jam production we have mentioned earlier. So for that jam production, the land revenue has to be paid every year. Land revenue has to be paid every year, and taxes should be paid every year. Insurance has to be paid every year. Depreciation of instruments will happen. That depreciation means the loss in value when it is used or it is not used. Whatever it may be, there will be a loss in the value of the machineries or buildings. Then permanent expenditures like permanent labor will be there in the factory. For them, they will give salary. So that is also will not change. So these things will not change even when the production is zero. That means there is no production. So we can take the current situation due to this COVID-19 outbreak. Even if there is no production, they have to pay the taxes, the insurance, depreciation and permanent expenditures, and land rent. So if this situation, the factory is running under rental land, it has to pay rent also. So these things will not change with the output level. Even if it is zero or it is making a large units, so whatever it may be, it has to be incurred. So that they are all called as the total fixed cost. In agriculture, the depreciation is major fixed cost, and rent. For rent, we will give the rent. Then permanent expenditures for permanent labors. These things will be common agricultural fixed cost. Then we will see about the total variable cost. So this total variable cost is, as the name indicates, it changes with the level of output or level of production. So when the jam making is zero, jam production is zero, we need not buy any fruits, any sugar, any chemicals. We don't require any labors or electricity. But when we want to increase the jam production from 0 to 100 units, this all has to be increased. So when we want to increase this production into 100 to 1000, it has to be increased further. the fruit procurement has to be increased, sugar purchased should be increased, chemicals used should be increased, and everything has to be increased. These kind of variables are the expenditures are called as the variable cost. So these things are known as variable inputs, and for these variable inputs, as the production increase, we have to increase them also. So when we increase them, the cost incurred for purchase of them will increase. So that is what we mention it as variable cost. So in our agriculture, the seed, when we want to increase the paddy production, we have to increase the seed, and we have to increase fertilizers, the labor used, the chemicals used, that means chemicals means the plant production chemicals, then fuel used, etc. So in order to get high paddy production, so these two costs are major cost. So this together will form the total cost. So there are two cost, that is variable cost and fixed cost. When we add these two things, we will get the total cost. So in previous slide we have seen this PX1 into X1 and PX2 into X2. They are all variable cost. So the fixed cost will be a particular number. So land rent means it is 100 rupees per acre, like that it will be there. So this all other things are called as total variable cost. So this is the difference. So then we will see about the cost concepts. There are 7 cost concepts. One is fixed cost and variable cost and total cost. So fixed cost, we have seen that it will not change even when the production is zero, even when the production is maximum capacity, it will not change. So example, taxes or rent or the depreciation, etc. The variable cost, so it is the cost incurred for the variable inputs used, like seed, fertilizer, chemical, labor, etc. Then total cost. Total cost is the addition of these two costs. We will see the formula of these things. So TFC. TFC will be a number value. So it will be 1000 or it will be 100 or 1000, whatever it may be, it will be a value. Variable cost is calculated by finding the unit input with its price. So as we have seen earlier. So total cost is addition of TVC and TFC. So these two together is the total cost. So total cost is PX into X plus TFC or TVC plus TFC. Then we will see about average fixed cost and average variable cost and average total cost. So it is nothing but average. We have seen the average physical product in the last class. It is similar to that. So average means when we ask a biker, a bike rider, what is the mileage of your bike, he will tell us that it is 60 km per liter. So that is average. So he will tell it as average is 60 km per liter. The similar thing for production of 1 kg of jam. 1 kg jam, how much fixed cost is used? How much fixed cost is used? That will give the average fixed cost. So then how much variable cost is used for producing 1 kg of jam? So this is output. So this is output. So output is regarded as Y. So this Y Then we will see the their formula. So AFC equal to total fixed cost divided by Y. So AFC equal to total fixed cost divided by Y. That is total fixed cost incurred per output. So for 1 kg of jam, how much fixed cost is used? So it explains how much fixed cost is used per 1 kg jam production. Similarly for our paddy also. For 1 kg of paddy, how much total fixed cost is used? So variable cost. So this is total variable cost divided by the output. So average variable cost is given by total variable cost per output. So it will also how much, it will tell us how much variable cost is used per production of 1 kg of output. So then average total cost. Average total cost is calculated by the total cost divided by output. The total cost incurred per output, or it can be arrived in other ways also. So we know that fixed cost plus variable cost will give total cost. So average fixed cost and average variable cost will give the average total cost. So therefore it can also be found by either using the formula AFC plus AVC. And the seventh concept and final concept is marginal cost. So as we know that marginal means change. Change is denoted by the form delta. So how much total cost is changed for one unit change in output? That will give us the marginal cost. So the marginal cost equal to delta TC divided by delta Y. So how much total cost has to be changed for one unit increase or one unit change? So these things will give the seven cost concepts. So these are all called as seven cost concepts. Let's see their graphs too. So first one, fixed cost. So fixed cost, here we use Y. Now instead of X, we don't require X here. We use output in the X axis and cost in the Y axis. So cost in the Y axis, output in the X axis. So whatever may be the output, it may be one unit or 2 unit, 3 unit or 1000 unit. The total fixed cost is same. Let's say that it is 1000 rupees. So when it is 1000 rupees, whatever may be the output, it will not change. The cost incurred even when the output is zero. Let's say that when it is zero also, we have to pay 1000 rupees. So we can take the example of taxes or depreciation. Whatever we have done for production, or whatever we have not done for production, we have to pay the fixed cost. So this is how the fixed cost curve will be. Then variable cost. So variable cost, so it will increase in the first stage, but at a slower rate, because in initial stage we don't require much use of fertilizer, labor, etc. So then when we matures, it will take more cost for harvesting, etc. So the total variable cost will increase. So for a particular company also, in the initial stages, it will produce little quantities. So when it goes on, increases its production, the cost will increase. So for example, let's take the example of jam company. So fruit jam company, when it produces 100 unit per year, it will incur this much cost. So 100 unit will be, is a very less amount. So its maximum capacity is, let's take it is 1000 units. So if it want to increase furthermore, let's say that it is taking 5000 outputs. So it is want to produce 5000 output, the total cost will increase. So we know that we have to increase the variable input also. For example, the seed, fertilizer, sorry, etc. So in our case, fruits, sugars are all to be increased. So in initial stage, it will be very less. Let's say that it is 50,000 for these units. But it will take, so 100,000. So this cost will increase. So this variable cost will vary. Then total cost. So total cost is, we know that addition of total variable cost and total fixed cost. So this is total fixed cost and this is total variable cost. When it is added, we will get this curve. So this three curves is used for finding the total cost. So these three curves will be separately drawn in a graph and the rest of the curves will be drawn in a graph separately. Then we will see about average fixed cost. The average fixed cost is the formula is total fixed cost per output. So when the output increases, the total fixed cost will decrease. So we will get a graph like this, the flat curve. So the flat curve is called as average fixed cost. So we can see that average fixed cost will fall as output increases because the fixed cost is spread over more units now. So we will get a graph like this. We can see the difference. The total fixed cost is here. So as we have mentioned, it is, let's say that it is 1000 rupees. Now it will reduce, but it will not be zero. So whatever may be the output, it will not be zero. Or it will not go beyond zero. Then average variable cost. So average variable cost is the total variable cost per output. Total variable cost per output. So we know that as we have seen the graph of total variable cost. So the graph indicates that initially the variable cost will be low. When the production increases, the total variable cost will be high. Similarly, we will get the curve like this. A flattened U-shaped curve. So as output increases, average variable cost falls because of spreading of cost. But after the optimum level, it will the increase. Then average total cost. The addition of these two cost is average total cost. So it will be a flattened one. So then the final one is marginal cost. The marginal cost is found by the formula delta TC divided by delta Y. So in your example sum or wherever it is, when it is goes beyond zero or when it falls, you don't take the value. So you just draw like this. It should not come down. So it should not come down. Even the value is -1, -2, -3, whatever it may be, you need not write those things. You have to write for the positive values. So like this, the graph will be there. So the marginal cost curve is U-shaped. So it is relatively high at small quantities of output. Then as the production increases, declines and reaches minimum value, then rises. So this is the minimum value, then rises. So as the output increases, it reduces the minimum value and it increases. So this average cost curves. So these four curves. First we have seen this third three curves in a graph, and we will see these four curves in a graph. So we have to draw these four curves separately in a single graph sheet. So this AFC has drawn, and ABC, AC and MC has been drawn. So we can note that this MC curve, this marginal cost curve, will cut the average variable cost and average cost curve at its lowest point. So at its lowest point. So these two point, so whatever the graph, whatever the curve you take, it will be cutting at its lowest point. This average, it is also the marginal cost curve, also known as supply. So we know that supply, so as the what input increases, as the price increases, the supply increases. So similarly, this curve is similar to supply curve. So when the supply did not meet the average variable cost, that means when the production does not meet the average variable cost, for example, for the jam company, when the production does not meet the purchase of jam, purchase of fruits, sugar, chemicals, etc., for labor wages, so they will not continue the production. They will shut it down. So that is why it is called as shutdown point. So similarly, when the farmer don't hit his variable cost, like the cost he used for seed, chemicals, fertilizer purchase, not including the fixed cost, so he will shut it down because he don't get any profit. So at this point, when it is meeting its lowest point, so average cost is fulfilled. So the supply will meet the average cost. That means there is no profit. The profit will at this point will be zero. So it is called as break-even point. Break-even point. So these two concepts are very much important. So one is shutdown point, where the farmer will shut down the business because it doesn't meet his average variable cost. When in this point, the break-even point, so where the production is just enough to recover the cost used, there is no profit. After these units only, the farmer will get benefit. So after these units, so up to this unit, if the production is here, they will shut it down. If the production is here, they will run and they can reach the break-even point. Break-even point means there is no profit nor no loss. So at this point only they can get benefit. So this is the average cost curve. You have to mention the shutdown point and break-even point in your graph also. So for your exercise sum, you have to calculate all the seven cost concepts by using the given formula, and you have to draw two graphs for a sum. So this total cost curve will be drawn in a single graph, and average cost curve should be drawn in a single graph. So this is the cost concepts. Now let's see about the returns. So return is nothing but selling of output. When we sell it in the market, we get the revenue. So the revenue from the production is called returns. So we can use the form where the words revenue and returns interchangeably. So selling of farm outputs like paddy or milk or egg, so that will give us the return, or we simply tell it as income. So we use the word, mostly we use the word income, income revenue or income received, like that we use to tell. So it is estimated by multiplying the output quantity with its price. Let's say that the paddy production is 1000 kg, total paddy production is 1000 kg and the price per kg of paddy is 20 rupees, then the return is equal to 20,000 rupees. The return is equal to 20,000 rupees by multiplying the price into its quantity. So how much output we got and what is the price of the output. So price of output, output is regarded as Y and price of output is regarded as P of Y, then the total return is PY into Y. Similarly, it is only for paddy. When it is for milk, so let's say that it is 1000 liters we have produced and 40 rupees per liter means, so we get 40,000 rupees. So similarly, formula is added with the subscript 1. So PY1 into Y1 plus PY2 into Y2. So this, that will give the total return. Then let's see about profit. The profit is what is the benefit we realize after meeting the expenses from the production. We are doing production in order to get some profit. So that is return calculated by total return minus the total cost. So what is the return realized and minusing the efforts extended. So net profit is calculated by the formula TR minus TC, total return minus total cost. So total return we can find it, and total cost we can find it by finding TVC and TFC. So that is net profit. There is one more term is called as gross profit. Gross profit means total return minus total variable cost. When we ask a farmer what is the profit of his farm, he will tell that it the gross profit only. He will not count for the total fixed cost. So he will not count total fixed cost. So this is a technical term only. Most of them they won't use. So that is why we use it to calculate gross profit. So here gross profit is calculated by total return minus total variable cost. Here we won't account the fixed cost. So this is how profit is estimated. So for the given sum or given example, you can find the total profit also. So gross profit also you can find and net profit also you can find. So today we have seen about different cost concepts and the returns and profit. Thank you.